If you pulled LR Tech Gogeta, then, you know, I'm not salty. Don't talk to me. Even if you didn't pull Tech Gogeta, or if you're going for this man in the future, then this video is 100% for you. We're talking about the best possible team that you can make, in my opinion, for LR Chad Gogeta. But before we hop into it, let's just get the subscriber challenge out of the way, because I know I'm already sensing some saltiness in my, you know, bloodstream, I guess. I don't know what I'm saying. Listen, it's very simple. If you pulled LR Tech Gogeta and you're watching this right now, then you have to subscribe, all right? I can't believe you clicked on this video with him in your box. Now, if you don't have him, I feel you. I understand your pain, and I'm going to let you off the hook for subscribing today, and I'm going to get you to subscribe in tomorrow's video. I do appreciate you guys coming through. Let's hop straight into this video. So, again, LR Tech Gogeta, as you guys know, just dropped on Global Dokkan. Now, the way I wanted to build this team, again, in my opinion, the best team you can make with this guy, I wanted to pair him up immediately with this Vegito. The issue with that is that they share some teams, right? They share Super Saiyans, Kamehameha, which are two of his greatest teams, honestly. Like these two, right? They also share, they share Pure Saiyans, right? Yeah, they share Pure Saiyans, Final Trump Card, Joined Forces, etc., etc. But they don't share things like Fusion, right? Or Connected Hope or Time Limit. So team building for these two were definitely a little bit difficult, but I think I made it work. So for the leader of your team, you're going to want this Kaioken Goku. I should also mention that this, again, this is a 7-character or unit team. You have to have all 7 units to go ahead and actually get this, or to build this team. If you don't have certain units, that's completely fine. This is not for beginners, obviously, or, you know, not beginners, but this isn't for people who are not whales, or maybe you just don't get lucky. So keep that in mind. Hopefully you can build towards this team if you like this team in the future. But yeah, you got to have these units. I can talk about some replacements at the end of the video, but let's just go through it. Let's just get through it for now. So I think this guy is definitely the best lead for this whole team. He does lead Super Saiyans, which is the category that we're going to focus on for today's video. So he gives that category 3 key, which is good. 170% to HP and attack. Now, I really like this type of leader skill, especially for this team. Even though he doesn't give 170% to defense, what this team is capable of, it doesn't matter. I'm telling you that right now. It does not matter, so just hear me out, okay? So this guy, again, giving HP and attack 170%. So your Gogeta and Vegito rotation obviously is going to be at full power, so keep that in mind. This guy's also really powerful defensively, so you don't have to worry about him holding back the team, okay? So this is your leader. This is your leader unit. Your first main rotation is Chad Gita and Vegito, okay? Now, these guys, I don't think I really have to explain too much. How many links do they share? They share, I know, the Super Saiyan, Fuse Fighter, Kamehameha, Prepare for... Dude, they share 6 out of 7 links, right? Super Saiyan, Fuse... Yeah, so they don't... So the only thing they don't share is Golden Warrior. This guy's Golden Warrior, and this guy has Power Sword by God. Yeah, so... Dude, so when it comes to links, they share Fuse Fighter and Prepare for... Wow, I can't speak English. Prepare for Battle is 4 key and 10% to attack and defense. And then they have Fierce Battle 20, Super Saiyan, so 35% attack on top of 10. They share 2 key, 45% attack, and 10% defense, and then they share an extra 25% attack on super attack. These two units, bro, they don't need that. And dude, these guys are so freaking broken together. This guy puts out insane damage. This guy defends very, very well while also putting out insane damage. Both of these units heal, providing a lot of providing the team more, you know, longevity. You don't really have to use items when it comes to these units, because again, this guy has a 50% heal. This guy's a 30% heal. This guy has some more damage reduction. This guy can change rainbow orbs, which helps both of these units get 18k super attacks. This guy can see enemy super attacks. So can this guy. Dude, like, I'm telling you, you do not... It doesn't get more broken than this, okay? I would say this is probably one of the best rotations in the game, if not the best, in terms of power and defensive capability. So you really want to run these two together, and you definitely want to get the fusions off. So when it comes to their fusions, for this guy, literally just enter, what, the fourth turn with 70% HP or more. So that's very, very easy, honestly. And then for this guy, it is enter the fourth turn. Yeah, when HP is 77% or less. So you could actually have both of these units on, like, the second rotation, and you enter the turn with, like... Well, I mean, if you enter the turn with 75% HP, one of them will fuse, but the other one won't, right? Because they're going to heal. So, you're going to see the... It's not hard to see this transformation. Just keep that in mind. So, again, these units are very, very powerful, and you definitely want to run them on the same rotation. For our next rotation, you want to have either the lead or your friend Namek Goku here with, again, the same Super Saiyan's Leader skill linked up with this guy, okay? Now, keep this in mind. This Gohan, yeah, he doesn't really put up the craziest numbers, but this Gohan is still one of the better defensive units in the game with his ability to stack attack and defense on both 12 and 18 ki. And he shares literally all seven links, even when this guy transforms, which you're really going to see, but you never know, right? If this guy were to transform, they still share all seven links with this Chad right here. And this guy's also a defensive monster. So what's going to happen is these two units right here, if this is going to be for like the first, maybe for like the first two or three turns, they might take damage. But after that, dude, after all the super attacks, these two units right here are not taking damage. Hear me out. These two units right here are not taking damage, sharing every single link, stacking defense relentlessly. They're not going to take damage. So you have one very powerful defensive solid rotation, and then another rotation here of just pure offensive madness while they're also defending very, very well. And again, you can say, you know what, Mr. Baby, the issue is, though, is that they only give 150% defense, which is still good, right? But you can definitely argue that. My counter argument to that is that these both of these units, when they fuse, guess what? They can see enemy super attacks. Not only will these units, these two as a rotation, benefit from being able to see super attacks, that way you know who to put where, but these two, who don't even need that ability, will still be able to see super attacks. So therefore, even if you do get attacked, you can still play around and know what's coming, when it's coming, and you can basically play your best hand. And that's, again, for a team like this, it's super, super, super powerful. So keep that in mind, okay? So far we have five units, right? We have the leader. Dude, I'm so excited to speak about this. I keep freaking stuttering. I apologize. Anyways, you have your leaders, Namek Goku, then your first rotation of Gogeta and Vegeta. That's three units. Then your second rotation of Namek Goku and Super Saiyan Gohan as your second rotation. That's five units in total. We still need two units. And these two units here are going to be the floaters of the team, right? There's three floaters per team. So the first floater would have to be either the friend or the your friend lead or your actual own Namek Goku. Keep that in mind. But the first floater I want to talk about is someone that I don't even have, but many of you do, and many of you flex this man on me all the freaking time. All right, it is the what do they call him? High School Gohan, right? Yeah, dude, this guy is very, very powerful, especially as a floating unit. This guy gives himself 50% attack and defense, which is really not that crazy, but 58% damage reduction is very, very good, okay? This guy also gives all super class allies 2 ki and 30% to attack and defense. So imagine giving this rotation another 2 ki and extra attack and defense that they don't need. And so imagine giving this rotation extra ki that they don't need and attack and defense that they don't need. And while being very powerful in terms of defense in that last slot. Now, sure, like in the legendary Vegeta event, which is even out on global yet, so you don't have to worry about that. This guy could easily get cream pied in there. I understand that. I mean, by normals, I don't know how much damage he'll take by normals, but I mean, like, I think, Super Tech, he's dead. I'm pretty sure of that. But other than that, like, I think you're going to be fine. And this guy, again, is supporting as a floater is like the best thing you can really ask for, especially when they're really, really good defensively. Okay. Now, the last unit here, again, this is the issue with when it comes to building this team. But the last unit I chose was this AGL Super Saiyan Gotenks. So this makes a full team here, right? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 characters. Now, the thing is with this unit is that this unit, again, is actually very powerful by himself, right? He does attack every single ally on the team with a medium chance of studying. So it's very powerful in difficult content, right? Which is very good to have a powerful unit in difficult content. That's not one of your main rotation units, so don't sleep on that. He also raises defense in that last slot. So the better defense he's going to have, the better he's going to be able to defend, obviously, which is crucial for third slot units. Now, the big, big, big thing about this guy, okay, is this support ability. The only thing is, though, the support ability only benefits this Gogeta because this Gogeta is on time limit, whereas you're not, right? Well, it doesn't matter because they're never going to see each other anyways, but that's like the main issue I have with this team. But again, forcing these two to be on the same team will create some issues like that. I was trying to look for a unit that can buff both of these units, but then there's no 3-key 40% support for Super Saiyans. There's none for Final Trump Card. There's none for Pure Saiyans. There's none for Joined Forces. You know, Kamehameha actually has this very interesting full power Jackie Chun unit that actually supports. Let me actually see if I can find him down here. Where is he? Yeah. So this guy, I mean, he's not like, he's not bad, right? Three key, 80% attack and defense start of each turn. Attack and defense plus 150% when performing a super attack. And then Kamehameha categories, allies, 3 key, and 30% attack. So this guy, again, he's not bad at all. Fully built up, he could actually be a very powerful third slot unit. And I'm not here to argue that. First, his links suck, okay? In terms of this team here, with all these other Super Saiyans, his links suck. Secondly, he doesn't really raise defense on super attack other than this buff right here. So even though it's 150, which sounds like a lot, his stats are not going to... It's not going to be as crazy as what it sounds like, right? So it would have been beneficial if he great, like, dude, if he greatly raised defense on super attack, he would be a really nice option. And then the last thing here is that he doesn't give defense, right? Defense is what wins modes in Dokkan. Sure, you can hop into a really easy mode and just blow things away with these two, that's fine. But in difficult content, if you cannot defend, you do not win. Unless you have, like, Devil Man, which I think he's restricted in the events nowadays. But if there's like a Devil Man type unit that just one shots, that's fine, right? But until that meta comes to Dokkan, defense is what allows you to actually, you cannot win the GT Legendary Goku event or Legendary Vegeta event without good defensive units, right? Because 90k defense, 100k is just not cutting it unless they have like a 1,000,000% damage reduction. But you get the point, right? So this unit right here, not giving defense, I think is definitely a big issue. But let's say this unit gets an easy A, right? Greatly raise attack and defense, key plus one up to 5, attack and defense and plus 30% maybe up to 120, and then attack and defense plus 150 on super, and then Kamehameha allies, 4 key and 40% to attack and defense. I say 4 key because, again, his links, you're not really sharing with many teams that, or with many units that are going to actually be on the Kamehameha category. So keep that in mind. This guy is a decent option if you have him, or at least you pulled him from the recent world tournament, but he's not really going to be the craziest, most possible option you could run. So please keep that in mind. That's why I do think this guy's the better option. He can, you know, his links, he does share links, especially with this team right here, an extra 2 key just from the Fuse Fighter link right there. Beautiful. And prepare for battle, right? So he's giving actually 4 key to both of these units just from the link, whoever is in that second slot. So yeah, hopefully you guys, you know, can build this team. If you can't, that's completely understandable. Hopefully one day you can work towards this team. Again, you could tell me, Mr. Baby, you know what, I think this unit works together, that's fine, right? This is just my opinion. This is the most cohesive team in terms of key attack and defense, support, defense, all of that stuff. This is the most cohesive team I can think of. Again, let me know what you guys think. Hopefully this video was of some value to you. And I will be streaming my summons very, very soon. So stay on the lookout for that. I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.